Hey everybody, I'm Destin Legends, and today we are going to be playing some more Crusader Kings 2. This is our Let's Play Spain playthrough. I guess we're starting off in the Kingdom of Galicia. I think it's Galicia. Yeah, Galicia. I'm always so, I guess you'd say, paranoid about mispronouncing the names of these little territories. But I believe we left off last time in the middle of a war. And I was doing really, really well at first. I actually got up to, I think, over 70% victory before I started to lose the war, because I am currently trying to take control of this county from my king, which would leave him basically powerless. He would just own this one down here and basically put me in a prime position to completely take over the country. But, you know, I was able to defeat the king's army, and I think Leon jumped in to help out my king as well, and I was able to defeat his army. But then all of these nations over here, I guess it's just the two of them, also sent troops over, and that was just way too much for my men to handle. So I've been losing for the past couple months, I believe, but I was about to surrender and just kind of give in when I decided, you know, I've kind of sacrificed a lot, spent a lot of money, a lot of time and troops trying to take this county. I'm going to let it play out before I just surrender, because you never know. Like, these guys might actually, you know, find some reason to pull their armies out. And one thing that I thought that I could do is I have these sons and daughters. I have my heir and two daughters that I could potentially marry off to these guys. I can't arrange a betrothal. So I think because I'm at war, so I cannot arrange a betrothal. But maybe I can acquire a powerful ally that would help me out with this. I don't think Castile. No, Castile has not done anything yet. Like, they haven't decided to declare war against me or to help me out. But maybe if I could betroth the new king of Castile, because he's just a boy, he's 9 years old, to one of my daughters. This one's my daughter, she is brave, and that would give me an ally. That would ally me with Castile, and Castile is kind of powerful right now, at least for one of these northern Christian nations, like, not necessarily compared to some of these southern Muslim nations. But with this alliance, if he'll come to war and help me, I should be able to secure victory over my king and his allies. But we're not going to stop there. I still have one daughter and one son. The king has a brother. Maybe I can arrange a betrothal between him and my next daughter. That would give me an alliance. Oh, no, it wouldn't. Wait, would it? I forget where it says. I think that little flag tells you whether or not you get an alliance with them. I'm pretty sure. I know it says matrimonial marriage. But I'm pretty sure it's the flag that is actually the indicator of whether you get an alliance with them or not. Well, we'll hold off. Like, let's take a look around. Ooh, England's in kind of some trouble. Not a whole lot going on in Ireland. Maybe I can get Barcelona as an ally? Let's see. Oh, how old is... He's got a 20-year-old daughter. How old is my son? 11. So, if she is not married yet... No, she is married, so that's not even a possibility. Like, I definitely... she's got a widowed... widowed daughter. She's a homosexual, though. So, that won't really be good for my son if I were to betroth him to her, because already she's kind of older, and with, like, less fertility, I don't really think that's something I want. And what is this? Where did you guys pop up from? Are you... What the hell is the... This is the Republic of... Doria? Srinidash, What was it? The Republic of Genoa. So I didn't even notice that he injured these territories down here. But he would probably make a really good ally. Who's he at war with right now? He's at war with Barcelona. So maybe, let's see. Oh, he's got so many children. Is that proud? We don't want a dwarf, really. This one's kind. How old? She's 10 as well. So, for political gains, I would like to betroth my son to your daughter. Only... my son would take a huge prestige hit from marrying her, but I think I need him as an ally right now. My son will have plenty of time to build up prestige. We need allies, so we've got to betroth him. Now I have one more daughter to marry off or whatever. Actually, I had to check the time. I'm going to try and make this episode at least 20 minutes and keep my episodes to like 20 minutes or so from now on, because it seems more appropriate to me anyway. So let's see. Did I even check France? Yeah, France has nothing for me. But I could get a Duke. A Duke of France as an ally. No, because I only have one daughter. It can't be this guy, because he has no sons. He has a couple sons, and I have a daughter to betroth, so I'll take your eldest son. Wait, what is he? He's got a lisp and he's cruel. The next one's a dwarf, and the next one hasn't developed any traits yet, so my next youngest daughter, she's 8 years old, I'd like to betroth, and I'll get an alliance out of that too. So, gotta let time pass. Hopefully, Navarra and Aragon don't crush me completely before these like alliances, you know, pop up and I get some kind of benefit out of them. I've gotta get my troops together, hopefully crush Aragon's army, and then just play defense. So we've got a message from Castile to the magnificent Duke Nuno II. Your wisdom and mercy are legendary. I've decided to accept your suggestion of betrothal between De Doria and Sancho III. Now, okay, wait a second. And Genoa has agreed to betroth their daughter to my son, so that's extremely good news. Except for the prestige hit my son is taking. So paradoxically, the language in this game is insane. But a siege camp is ripe target for bandits, although there are many that... I'm so bad at reading these. Okay, we're gonna do this properly. Paradoxically, I can't pronounce that, I'm sorry. A siege camp is ripe for bandits, although there may be lots of soldiers there. They are all looking the wrong way. A series of raids have led to some loss of life amongst the attackers, Vene du Castlo, as they attempted to repel them. So the attacking troops lose 1%, which is good. That's essentially saying this guy here, while he was like sieging my fort, my town, or whatever he's sieging right now, he was attacked by bandits, which is sweet. And it looks like the Duke of France has agreed to the betrothal as well, and I actually don't think... No, because Castile is also allies with my king. He won't be coming in to help me out anytime soon. And I don't think that I can manually request aid from these guys. Whoopsie. I think a little icon just pops up when you're able to do so. So hopefully I get an option for that. I may be able to hire some mercenaries soon to deal with this crowd here, And if I can do that and survive, I will hopefully have won this war. Look at these soldiers marching up north. So again, the people sieging my counties are taking more losses as they do so, which is good for me. I'll try and read as many of those little pop-ups as I can. I know I butcher them so badly, but you know, I'll get better at it as I go. Alright, let's see how this battle goes. Hopefully in my favor, because I have numbers on my side and I really need to win. But the last time I fought up here, terribly, terribly. Yeah, it's still kind of even right now, even though like I have like such a huge number advantage. But I did emerge victorious in the end, which is great. Will the king accept peace? Nope, he still says it's indecisive. So I'm gonna chase down, I believe that's Aragon's army. He will regret interfering with my war. And after I have them like completely smashed, I'm gonna go and hunt down the king's army, because there's no way I can deal with this right now. I've gotta hope either Aragon pulls back their army, or I've gotta like save up enough money to hire some mercenaries to duke it out with him. Or maybe I'll be able to win the war just like over time. Because you can see I started off with 70% with this episode, and I'm up to 75 now. Just by occupying the king's territory and by smashing Aragon's army right there. Okay, I've got another shot at this. again, paradoxically, a siege camp is ripe. It's a ripe target for bandits. Although there may be lots of soldiers there, they are all looking the wrong way. A series of raids have led to some loss of life amongst the attackers of Vinay and Caslo as they attempted to repel them. Which is great, and I didn't completely butcher it that time, so I'm happy about that. Ooh, I don't wanna... Nah, I'll keep reading this. Like, I'll probably only cast Crusader Kings tonight until I start to lose my voice, which is usually about like an hour or two. And, you know, of course, try and split it into 20 episode segments, 20, 25 or so. Ooh, so I actually got a prisoner here after smashing... No, that's Aragorn's army. Which is great. I can probably even ransom him back. No, I can't. Will you accept peace now, my king? Nope. So, the loss of Aragorn's soldiers don't weigh on my king at all. He does not care. Let's see if I have any reinforcements. Yeah, I can reinforce a little bit. Well, those soldiers are all gonna die. And that 8 are probably also gonna die. But I may as well use them up. That was a defeat. Another defeat, even though it kind of sets me back a little bit. Oh, I should have read that. It just said, during a various siege on my county here, I don't know, they did something that was able to lower the morale of my troops, which isn't good at all. So let's go hunt down. Actually, this is Leon's army. I thought that was my king's. And I need at least, I think, 90, maybe 100 gold before I can hire any mercenaries. Like, I could probably afford some now, but, you know, I need to be able to pay them for at least 2 to 3 months. So my bishop is no longer, I mean, the bishop Manuel is no longer my court chaplain. And I wonder why, what happened to him? He's still here, he just quit. Well, you're gonna have to do your job, man. Like, you don't get off just like that whenever you want. Actually, you know what? Wait, what's Leon's current state of diplomacy? He is fighting his own rebellion, so he needs to use all of his own troops to defend his own land. So, I think I will just hold my troops over in that county outside of my own country, because after Navari is done assaulting my own county over here, he might try and hunt down my army, and, you know, I can't deal with that. At least I don't think so. My troops might be like, you know, like, pull a miracle out of their ass and crush the Navarian army like Aragorn crushed my army. But my prisoner, Mundo Delor, is complaining about his dark cell in the dungeon, asking for more suitable accommodations, and I say, let him rot. Who is this? I don't think I've seen that faction before. What's this count here? He is currently attacking this fellow in the war for Toledo. And Castile is also involved. So Castile is trying to take over this. I guess that's alright. I actually hope that they're not too successful, because I don't want the Catholic nations to expand too much too quickly, because after I take over Galicia, I'm going to need to like take some territories myself, and it's easier to declare war on someone that's not of your own religion than it is to declare war on someone who is. And again, I've already read that twice, so I'm not going to read it again. Just bandits attacked attacking Navarian soldiers again, and they suffered 1% loss in troops, which is great. Actually, I never even considered I could assault Leon. My king still will not accept peace. Something's got to happen with Navaria. So I lost that little town that I was sieging there, which is no good. So here it says the defenders of Viena de Castello sallied forth but were caught unawares by some of the attackers. They lost many before limping back through the prison, the postern gate, and there were great cheers from the attacking encampment. So my guys tried to attack the enemy attackers, but kind of got mangled, so I'm going to lose a lot of morale. 5% troop losses, but the enemy loses 2.5% losses, and I can afford to lose more troops than he can right now. That's for sure. So all in all, like, that's not incredibly good, but it's not incredibly bad for me either. I'm trying to think, where should I send my troops? I'll just send them back up north. Hang out there, because it looks like Navari's gonna hang out on my county for a bit. 80 gold. I will spend the money to hire the mercenaries to finish this war if I have to. I might not have to, though, the way things are going. And it looks like Navari is really going to work here. They've taken 3 out of 4 of my holdings, and I hope when he's done here he goes to join in the war with Toledo rather than coming north and trying to eliminate my army. And let's quick see if I can reinforce. Not very much. I believe I can only reinforce 44 troops, so I'm going to leave them for now. Yeah, things kind of are going your way, my liege, but not for long. This is a long, incredibly long, costly war for me. Okay. I wonder if I disband. Oh, I can't disband here. I'm gonna have to run, because Navaria is actually gonna come north and chase me down. Or maybe he'll go and he'll stop and start sieging this holding. No, he's going after my army. So, I'm going to have to stand and fight, because he'll reach my army before they can get over to the next county. So I'm gonna have to stand and fight and hope for the best. And I can almost afford mercenaries, which is good. So it says, combat is the best teacher. Duke Nuno II of Portugal has become more proficient commander, which is excellent. I need all the experience in combat I can get. Pretty even fight so far, but it does look like Navarre's superior numbers are going to take over and completely demolish my army. But I did do quite a bit of damage there. Hopefully Navarre doesn't sit there and siege the holding that I took, because I can't afford to give that up. I'm going to disband this group right now, so I get all the money I can, and I imagine I'm going to be hiring mercenaries when I get to about 95 wealth, and sending them north. Oh, and it looks like even more rebellion here in Leon, which is good. Good for me anyway, because I can't afford to have Leon coming over and joining in the war again. Nothing else going on. Castile still attacking Toledo. And if I could call for assistance... I guess I can't call for assistance from this duke right now, because he's already involved in a war. And the same from Genoa. That's why... I believe that's why anyway. I'm like unable to get help from them, who are now my allies through betrothal. Actually, I think I'm gonna pause here, and we will call that episode number one for the day, and I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe, rate, and comment, because for every subscriber I do get, a Justin Bieber fan will die, and plus I really appreciate it, and it makes me feel good and everything. Ha ha ha, it's true. But I'm going right into the next episode right now, so I will see you there.